Hello everybody, AquaGear here, and welcome back to another mod review. Today we are redoing the video for the Attack of the Bee Team. Last time, as you guys know, I did do one, but I didn't go very deep in detail, and I didn't really follow any specific order. But today, we are going to go sort of deep inside. I'm not going to explain every mod very deeply, because there's so many mods and so many things you can do with each one, but I will go over almost every mod, except a few exceptions that I honestly don't feel comfortable doing. But I'm sure you guys will learn something new from this, because I have laid out a lot of things. So, with saying that, let's just hop right in. Welcome back, everybody. So, we have so many things to do, let's just hop straight in. First of all, we have the fossil mod. So, there's a lot of interesting things with this mod. I think you can, like, make dinosaur meats and stuff. You can find certain blocks, like ice stone, which is pretty cool. So, this is one of the mods who I do not want to go deep into, because I don't know much about it. But it is definitely a very cool mod. It involves DNA, some types of food. So, again, not going to go deep into that one because I don't know much about it. But everything else we probably will go deep into. Next is Redstone Plus. There was an entire mod dedicated to Redstone, but it was so complicated even for me that I just, one part of the Redstone I decided to skip, but I just brought out the easy stuff like different colored lamps, power rails, and landmines. So, landmines are obviously pretty cool. I'm actually gonna blow up something, yeah! Anyway, if we take a landmine, put it on the floor, actually stick a piece of TNT in it, it is now charged, and if you wanna maybe hide it, you actually have to put a block up top, and it'll hide it, but for some reason the colors are wrong, but that's just fine. If it was normal, it'd be green, and you probably couldn't see it at all, so if we step on it, boom, it explodes. So, pretty obvious. Next, we have rails that have different powers. I mean, they're like detector rails, power rails, but I think they have something a little special to them. So those are just kind of, they added more rails into the mod. Also, probably one of my favorite things is different colored redstone lamps. So they have like blue, gray, green over here. No, that's the next thing. Let's see what else. Cyan, lime, silver, brown, red. So yeah, they have a lot of cool stuff, especially the landmines. I love those landmines. Next is probably one of my favorite parts. It is the mod. It's the mobs. So we have things like evolved zombie, owl, evolved skeleton, but of course we are going to try every single one of them. There's, I think, maybe four or five mobs I did not include because I did not have enough room for them in the actual chest, so, but I kind of left out the bad ones, or non-useful ones. So real quick, let's just take a look at every single one of them. This is the mandrake. They make a very weird sound, and I do not like those things. Next, we have the horned huntsman, which is actually a boss. He looks very cool. Looks very strong, so yep, like I said, he's a boss. Next, the Ent. He's a tree! he's a literal tree. Next, what are we looking at? The Owl. Which is pretty cool, I guess. Next is the Toad. Which, as you could probably guess, is just a little froggy thing. The Nightmare. These things are weird. Yeah, these things are, oh wow, yeah, I don't like that thing. Let's just get away from it. Baby Yaga. Yeah, that thing's like a witch, kind of like an advanced boss witch, which is cool. The Coven Witch. I think this is just kind of like a mob. It doesn't really attack you unless you attack it. Next is the Bliss. So I'm guessing it's just a blaze, but with ice. So real quick, let's just get rid of a lot of these and go to the next ones, which we have next up in line. Okay, so let's grab the second row. Whoa, okay. Let's grab the second row. So next is the Roaster. Roaster? I know this thing like how normal chickens do eggs, I think. Poops out flowers. And I think like red dye and all that kind of stuff. Next is Evolved Zombie. And it's burning, but yep, it has like a spacing on its head and it's a lot stronger than a normal zombie. Next is Evolved Skeleton. That looks awesome. That actually looks pretty cool. Except its bows are a little bit weird, but whatever. Next is the teddy bear, which I'm guessing is just a little scary thing that crawls up in the middle of the night, which is just fine. Except it could be a little scary. Next is a night crawler. This thing looks really weird. If I saw this in my world, I'd probably scream. Next is the alien bill. What's up with your head, dude? It looks like you're suffocating. Anyway, Pixie. Reminds me of from The Legend of Zelda. Isaac. Oh, that thing is weird. I know you can like spawn in different parts of Isaac, which is probably the weirdest. And next is the Ender Dragon, which I'm kind of scared to spawn in because it'll destroy everything, but I think it's a nice one. Yeah, it's a nice Ender Dragon. Whoa there, dude. Anyway, yeah, let's get away from those. And let's get rid of these and do the next wave, and then we will get on with the mod showcase review, whatever you guys really want to call it. Okay, next mobs. Next is a slimeling, which is has to do with the Galactocraft mod, I'm pretty sure. The one where you go up in space and the moon and stuff. Next is the wasp. Oh, these things are annoying. I do not like those things. The noise just drives me crazy. Evolved skeleton, which is again just kind of thing with a spacesuit on, but it's much stronger. Evolved creeper, same thing. Evolved creeper boss. Whoa. Hello there, dude. Yeah, I think this thing's like an actual boss in a dungeon or something. Tree feed. I'm sorry, I don't know how to pronounce that. That's a little bit weird. Are they fighting? Demon, which you find in another, I'm pretty sure. It's just a guess. Hamster. Where are they going? They're falling into the ground. Anyway, these things, you can put them in balls, play around with them. These are really cool. A lot of people like this mod, and so do I. They like to follow you and stuff. So yeah, you can do a lot of things with these hamsters. Next is the glob, which is just like a dirty slime, which is gross. But yeah. Now let's head over. Do the hamsters spawn to me? Hopefully not. I don't want them following me. Anyway, let's head back over here, landmine, and keep going with the mod showcase. Next is weapons and random, and these things have disappeared. But actually, we have to do this first before this. One cool thing about Attack of the B Team is that if you kill something, you actually turn into it. So if you go to your keyboard, look at the brackets, the things that looks like a U but sideways. If you click on them, this will pop up. These are the animals or mobs that you have killed, and if you click on it, you turn into it. And how to get different animals is obviously you kill them. So if I want to turn into a zombie pigman, I click it and I'm turning into one. And now if I go to F5, I'm a zombie pigman now. So yeah, that's really just about it. But since there's so many mobs in this game, there's a lot of possibilities, and there's special powers. Like if you're a wasp, you can fly. If you're a ghast, you can fly, and different things like that. So I had three t test subjects here, but they all kind of disappeared, so I can't do it. But you guys know what I mean. Next is the weapons and random. So here I have a couple cool things: a cloud in a bottle, statue mod, weapons, and dubstep guns. So let's just grab the interesting things: the cloud in a bottle, statue mod, javelin, all the dubstep guns, and maybe just one. We'll grab obviously the launchers and just a couple of the weapons, maybe. Okay, so first of all, probably my favorite in all of these is the cloud in a bottle. If you throw this, it turns into a cloud. You can have a lot of fun with these, just kind of flying around making clouds. Yeah, so I definitely played around with this. It's very, very, very cool. Ba, 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 ba. I honestly, I could play with this all day, just throw them around making clouds. Let's get rid of that. Next, I will show you the statue mod, which is very, very, very useful for pictures. Like if you want to maybe get a profile picture for your YouTube, like I did. I actually made mine using the statue mod. But if you guys want to do it, you just need two blocks. And you gotta take a hammer and hit it. This is where the main part comes in with the statue mod. So with these levers, you can change his position and everything. Obviously, there's your guy. Now, if you want a certain skin on there, you just gotta type in the name. So I'm gonna type in my name, which is Aqua Gear. Now, like that, DGF. And guys, look, it's my skin. So I just wanna do that and sculpt it. Then if you let me time set. day, real quick. So as you guys can see, it's not colored, but it is my skin. But if you do want to color it, get the palette, and shift and click on it. That will give it color. So hey guys, look, it's me. Hello, different Aqua Gear. So yeah, I really love the statue mod. Also, you could put stuff in his hands, like if you want to put a javelin in his hand, if you want to put a big meat thing in his hand, yeah, you could put stuff in his hand, you could put armor on him, you can do anything with him. So let's get rid of the statue mod. Next, we'll look at some of the dubstep guns. These are guns that make music. So I will be quiet for a little portion of the time, and I will play each song. So this is called the Bat Killer. Alright guys, so let's go back to the Bat Killer real quick. Yeah guys, I don't know. Alright, so we already tried out the first dubstep gun and the Bat Killer. Next, we'll look at the explosive dubstep gun, and this will destroy stuff, so I gotta be careful. Alright, so as you guys can see, it exploded stuff. And next we have the dubstep circular gun. Alright guys, so those were the dubstep guns. So they're really cool. Some of them are explosive, some of them are just fun. Next, we'll look at the Nyan Pig Launcher and the TMPP Launcher. So let's look at the Nyan gun first. And this obviously just shoots out a pig that makes rainbows and explodes. So you can see it's just running around, and at one point it's going to go boom. Pretty cool. Next is a TMPP Launcher, which I think is just another pig, but I haven't tried this one out, so let's see what it does. Does it ever stop? Does it explode? Yep, it explodes, and it's gone. So those are the two launchers, which are very cool. Next, we have just the frozen meat, which is just like a sword. Javelin. I love these, because I think it's gone. That's awesome. Because I think you can throw javelins. Yeah, you can. So the other javelin is just like this one. You just throw it, which is awesome, by the way. We got other things like ancient javelin. I'm not sure if you can throw this one. Yeah, you can. That's awesome. Whoa. That's actually really cool. We have like gem axe, gem hoe, gem sword, and chisels from different mods. So I'm just going to forget about that one. But these are, again, just kind of other swords, which are awesome. So let's head back to the little area and do our thing. But let's get rid of the slime. Yeah, let's just kind of punch it over there. I don't want the noise coming over here. So now we looked at all this stuff, which was cool, except the diamond javelin, another sword. This is, you can throw potions with that, which is awesome. And I just had a little lag spike, but that's all right. Next, we will look at advanced genetics. This is one of the mods that you can go so deep into that I'm not going to do anything. I'm just going to kind of show you guys different parts of it. But mainly what this mod does is you can inject yourself with different DNA to give you different powers, like water breathing, flying, etc. So that's really cool, but I'm not going to go deep into that. Next is the Carpenter's Mod, which is a lot of people's favorites, because you can take any block and turn it into any other block. So let's just take this block, the Carpenter's Block, a normal block. What if we want to make it into maybe a hay block? We click on it with the hay block, and bam, it turns into a hay block. But with the different tools, you can turn it into different things, like different sizes, different textures. So yes, the Carpenter's Mod is a lot of people's favorites, including mine. It is a very great mod, and before I forget, you can also do it with ladders and torches. You can change the texture of them to be of a different blocks, which I think it's the only mod that does that, which is amazing. Next, we have the Flans Mod, which is probably one of my personal favorites. It's guns. So, yeah, you have to have the gun and the specific ammo for it. And I don't know if it's gonna be too loud, but well, you can shoot things with it, obviously. Let's go over to the slime and teach it a lesson, not to interrupt my video. Where's my ammo? All right. All right, so we have to reload, and then we can shoot it. Yeah, so there's plenty of different guns. I just chose like three of them, which is awesome. How do I reload? Is it this? Stop. Do I even have the ammo for it? But anyway, let's check out the Dragunov. Bam. Which is awesome. And we, as you can see over here, I'm turning back into myself. And you have a zoom, which is awesome. But yep, that is a Flans mod. If you really want to check it out, go over to the Technic Launcher website, download the Technic Launcher, and Attack of the B Team will be there ready for you. So just a little info. And also, I'm pretty sure, hopefully I don't forget, I will put the link in the description to the Technic website. Next, let's look at the furniture mods. Well, I put mods, but it's only mod. I especially love this mod because it can spruce up your house quite well with different furniture that actually look like furniture, like tables. I have no idea what that is. Lamps, packages, couches, tables, different things like that. And we can also look at stuff like computers, which is awesome. This is a doorbell you can put on the wall. It just makes a sound when someone clicks it. Packages, chairs. So these are all pretty cool things. So I need to sign it. Well, I'm not gonna do that right now. TV. These are just a couple of things that you can put in the furniture mod. And I actually really love the furniture mod. You can make a pretty good house with all this stuff. Next is thermal expansion. This is another one I won't go very deep into because there's so much, but I'll just show you some of the ores like tin, copper, silver, lead, enderminium. No, endurium. I can't even say it. Tinker's alloy, Invar, Electrum, shiny ingot. Different wires, gears, and I don't know really much about the mod, but it's a really cool mod. I've played with it a little bit. Next is Tinkers, and Tinkers is huge. It's probably one of the biggest mods in this mod pack. And you have to build this whole contraption to make different tools, but I'm not gonna do that. If you guys really want to know, go on some website. They'll probably explain it better than me because it personally took me like a week to get it, but that's just me. So this is some of the weapons you can build. You can use different alloys, different metals, different ores to make different weapons like pickaxes, bows, long swords, hatchets, axes, arrows, pans, hammers, cleavers, everything. So yeah, I really love Tinker's Mod. And again, if you want to get more information, go on a website. They'll tell you way better than me. Next is Chisel, which is probably one of my favorite, again, another one of my favorite mods because it adds so many cool blocks that you don't usually get, like chiseled obsidian, moss stone. I already did obsidian. So there's a lot of cool things with this mod, and there's a lot of blocks. I only got a couple of them to show you guys, but really, again, download Attack the B Team because it is an amazing mod. Oh, that's pretty cool. It's like see-through brick. That. So, yeah. There's a lot of really awesome blocks in this mod. I mean, this mod is kind of mod pack, my bad, is really made to be like a wacky kind of mod pack to be kind of spontaneous and exciting. Next is Food Plus. This mod introduces different types of food like cooked chips, candy hose, bread and butter, ice cream, hot dogs, bread with Nutella, carrot soup, and these are all you things you can eat. Seaweed, muffins. I mean, like different tools made out of cotton candy. No, just candy, not cotton candy. Strawberry cake, toast, coffee beans. So they're all very good stuff, and I love this mod. Next, we have the hats, which is another one of my favorites. I have a lot of favorites, don't I? If you press H on your keyboard, you'll go to this screen. Here, you can pick different hats. So if you look on top of me, different hats will come up. And there's a lot of different hats. I have my favorites. I have the ones that I don't like, but it's all cool. There's actually a lot you can choose from. And how you get these in normal survival is, I think you gotta kill a mobs can have these hats on. You gotta kill those mobs to get their hat. That one's really, I really love that one. So I'm just gonna show you. Whoa, face hugger. These are just a couple of the ones. This one's really cool. Yeah, those are just a couple of the hats in here, which is amazing. Next, we have a couple of our honorable mentions, because since I didn't get to do every mod in here, I had to have some honorable mentions, which are Witchery, Galacticraft, Necromancy, Plants Mechas, and Generated Structures. Well, this is a different thing, but all these other ones are just mods that I didn't get to do because I didn't know much about them and I didn't feel like actually setting up their machines and stuff. So let's real quick look at the generated structures. We actually have a bunch of them all around us. This over here is a structure that a witch lives in. These spawn quite often, so they're not that rare, but I mean, if you want to bunk in a place for a night, there you go. So we've got a chest over here with some items, and of course, a witch. Usually, I just like to blow up those houses. And real quick, while I'm at it, this slime has a hat on. So that's how you actually get the hats. You kill them, and you get their hat. Next generated structure is this thing. Again, not very... it is very common, and witches spawn in here because there's spawners at the bottom. But if you come in the well, there's a dropper here with different things. And these... I will do a little quick review on. These are Pokeballs. Well, they're called Safari Nets, but really they are Pokeballs. What you do is you can go up to a mod and catch it. Well, I think I need to be in survival. But anyway, plus I haven't played around too much, but really there's different kinds of balls. There's one that are permanent, one that can be single use, but these are very, very cool. It's literally like Pokemon. You can catch any mob in them, but I won't go too deep into it. Next generated structure is obviously the villages. Mostly the villagers are the same, but there's a couple new things. I think there's a couple new buildings. There's like villagers with hats on, things like that. Like this guy over here, this guy's new. I think he's like a evil villager. That's so weird. Obviously, and they can be built out of different things. So yeah. And then we have one more generated structure that I want to show you is, again, not, it is very common, but still very cool. You can get a lot of hay from these. These things, whoa, lag, spawn naturally out throughout the world. And of course, they can give you a lot of hay, but they're just shaped as human beings, humans, whatever. So let's take the slow and tedious walk all the way back over. Whoa, you guys saw that car, right? I'm not just hallucinating. And we are actually almost done with the review, which is kind of sad, but we just got three more things to show you. One thing I thought was cool is wool slabs. They should really add this in vanilla Minecraft. It's just wool and a slab. Also, what I like is the detail on some of these mods. Like, you can have different colored crafting benches on what wood you use to make it from. And this is from Galacticraft, one of the mods that I did not cover, but this looks so cool, I had to put it in. But also, Galacticraft, you could also make rocket ships, actually go to the moon. There's entire dungeons, bosses, everything on the moon, different loot. Sorry I didn't get to go over it. It's actually really cool, but it would have taken so long. I think the actual video would have taken like a couple hours, so yeah, sorry about that. But I went over the mods that, in my eyes, are kind of the most important. Hello, Aqua Gear. Break you. So, yeah, guys, I hope you've sticked around this long. I know it's probably a very long video. But anyway, guys, thank you for watching. Make sure to leave a like and a comment as it supports my channel. And I'll see you guys later. God bless, and goodbye.